Yes, welcome back, dear viewers of Imam Hussein TV, specifically on the Morning Barakah show. We have had some fantastic discussions so far, and we're going to be continuing our fantastic discussions around health and wellness, specifically around the lung and the functions of the lung and the diseases associated with the lung, or the lungs, as we know now. But today we're going to be discussing quite a controversial topic, which is smoking, be it the cigarettes or the e-cigarettes, or as we know it, to be called the shisha, or in the American kind of countries, it's known as hookah, for our American viewers.
Is it?
Yeah. It's known as hookah in America. Don't ask me why I know. I've been to America, so I've
clearly we know what you've been up to in America. No, because actually in our countries it's called hookah as well. My nan used to do it.
Yeah. So we're going to be discussing the social aspect of that, as well as the kind of scientific aspect of that. And of course, with our kind of resident expert, Dr. Sayyid Yasser Madani. Thank you so much for once again being on the show. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How's it all going?
Alhamdulillah.
Brilliant.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. So, Ali.
Yeah.
Questions.
It's quite a topic that I'm really quite passionate about because, you know, growing up with the youth, speaking to the youth, it's something that it's a very attractive place to be or an attractive thing to do, peer pressure or whatever it is. And it's kind of like the norm now when it comes to cigarettes or shisha. But we'd love to discuss about the differences between cigarettes, it being a habit, for example, or shisha, it being like a once a week kind of social gathering kind of thing.
I think we should. I was going to say that we, for those of us, of you actually, that haven't joined us before, Dr. Madani is a specialist, a respiratory specialist. So that's why he's giving us his expertise on this topic. You were saying?
I was going to say, in terms of the difference between cigarettes and shisha, do you want to first start on kind of cigarettes, the effect that it has maybe on the lungs? And then comparing that to shisha. I know that you have some interesting facts you wanted to share.
Sure, okay. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين. So we know more about cigarettes in terms of the Western world. It's been studied more. It's been researched more. Shisha has come over from the East and it's now quite commonplace in the West, even in America, as Ali mentioned. Everywhere it's there's shisha cafes, but it's less well studied than cigarette smoke. We know that shisha contains tobacco. Tobacco is harmful. Cigarettes, in fact, contain thousands of chemicals. Some say over 5,000 chemicals. Wow. And all of them are very harmful.
Each cigarette?
Yeah, the cigarette. Yeah, exactly. There's a lot of social aspects attached to each of those.
Yeah.
Cigarette, it's an individual habit that people do for various reasons, and it becomes a habit and becomes a way for people to relax or what have you. But unfortunately, the more they use it, the more addictive they become to it, because it's actually a substance, it's a form of substance misuse or addiction, because it contains nicotine, which is the addictive substance within it. Shisha is slightly more social rather than individual. I mean, people still do shisha on their own, But often they do it more socially, when they get together as a group of friends or colleagues or what have you. So there's slightly more social element attached to shisha, which was probably the case for cigarette smoking many years ago as well. Yeah. When I have patients and I ask them, look, how much do you smoke? They say, I was just a social smoker, actually. Mm. Back in the day, 20, 30 years ago, I only smoked. I didn't smoke as a daily habit, which is not the case for most people that smoke. Most people that smoke daily, actually, that I see anyway.
Could I ask you just here? So those people you see that are from 20, 30 years ago, and say from that period they stopped, would the lungs continue to be damaged, or does the over time the lungs repair and then become as a non-smoker?
Yeah, so that's a very good question, actually. So actually, it takes years for the lungs to become damaged.
Right.
The lungs don't become damaged straight away.
All right.
I mean, some damage develops, but it's probably not clinically significant damage.
Right.
To the extent that it causes symptoms or disease.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay. So there's probably subclinical damage which isn't significant and doesn't manifest, but the significant damage happens years down the line, whether it's lung cancer. Or whether it's emphysema or chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD for short, which we're not going to talk about much in this episode. In fact, we have a I think a separate episode for lung cancer and a separate episode for COPD as well. Mm. So that happens years down the line. There's a lag of several decades, at least, you know, two to three decades or later, that the damage happens. Having said that, if the person has been a very, very heavy chain smoker for those short years, those 10 years that they have smoked, or 20 years that have smoked, and on top of that, if they have smoked other substances such as cannabis or heroin, we know those also cause emphysema. Mm-hmm. So they develop accelerated emphysema earlier than those that have smoked less, or those have only smoked tobacco and not cannabis and heroin. So classically, COPD gets diagnosed above the age of 35, 40. There are some people that can develop COPD actually slightly younger because they've smoked so much since they were, honestly, I've seen people that when I've asked them, when did you start smoking? They say, when I was 11.
Wow.
If you go to certain countries in the Far East now, you see people on the street, kids on the street, smoking at the age of 8, 10, 12. Yeah. And it's tragic. It's very sad to see, but it's actually the environment that it's about. You know, an 8-year-old doesn't know anything about cigarettes, but when they see an adult doing it, or when they see on the billboards, on the buses, or the advertisements, you know, it's all the subliminal messages going through. The, you know, they see it's cool to smoke, so why can't I do it? My dad does it. Why can't I do it? Yeah.
Do you think? So you've worked in charity in Iraq, aid work. Have you seen that sort of young children smoking? Is it something that's common there, or is it something that's just more prevalent in regions geographically in the world?
You know what? That's a very good question, and honestly speaking, I don't know the answer, because whenever I go to Iraq, I go in the busiest period in the year, which is Arba'een, and I go there generally for the purpose of doing this work that I do, and so I'm not there in other times of the year to see what people do and you know, mix with people, etc. There's a lot of smoking in Iraq. I don't know if it affects the kids or the younger people as much as it does elsewhere. It probably does. I don't have statistics. I can't give you numbers. But there's a lot of smoking in Iraq, unfortunately, and it has a lot of health.
And it's unfortunate, like you said, about the image of it being cool and, you know, glamorous, because that's where it started in the Western world, as being something that, you know, few privileged could do. Yeah. It was a social status, and over time, advertisements have tried to sort of undo that damage. And it's interesting you're saying that there are places in the world still it's seen as glamorous, and it's a shame that still exists, because it's far from it, isn't it? From your perspective,
would you say? Now we know much more about smoking, and it's interesting you mentioned that. There are in the early 1900s and, you know, around the time of the First and Second World War, we didn't know much about smoking. No. And in fact, even doctors used to smoke because we didn't know about the effects of smoking. And in fact, there are advertisements of doctors wearing lab coats giving their patients cigarettes
to relax.
That I've seen. Yeah. Our knowledge, you know, has changed dramatically. We now have much more data. There was one of the earliest reports that were published by the Royal College of Physicians in the UK in 1962, called Smoking and Health. You can actually Google it. You can see the scanned copy of the report. And that talks about the harmful effects of smoking. So we know that, you know, for example, if you smoke tobacco, each year that you smoke tobacco, it reduces your life expectancy by 3 months.
Wow.
So if you smoke for 10 years, 3 months times 30 months. So that's just over 2 years. Your life expectancy is reduced. If you smoke for 20, that's double.
Yeah.
You've reduced life expectancy by over 4 years, et cetera, et cetera. So it's the tobacco and all the harmful substances within you. And cigarettes, cigarette smoking affects your whole body.
Oh, really?
It causes cerebrovascular disease, so strokes.
Wow.
It's a risk factor for strokes.
100%.
Heart attacks. It causes narrowing and damages to the blood vessels in the brain and the heart, everywhere in the body. Narrowing of blood vessels in the legs, so where people, you know, get a stenosis, narrowing of the arteries, and reduce blood flow to the legs, which means they have to have an angiogram, open up that narrowing, or, you know, or put a stent in the legs, or in the, you know, whatever. So narrowing of the arteries can happen anywhere in the body, heart, brain, legs. It can cause lung diseases. It can affect the whole body. And if your health is bad otherwise, if you're obese or overweight, if you smoke, if you're unfit and you don't exercise, if you drink alcohol on top as well, yeah. all those things, if you do, drugs, substance misuse, all of those risk factors come together. If you already have pre-existing things, high yeah. cholesterol, high blood pressure, high diabetes, you're a walking time bomb, essentially, yeah. Yeah. for a stroke or a heart attack.
Yeah.
I mean, I'd love to also kind of, because this show is not about, you know, quit smoking. It's just about being informed, mm. right? And you can make an informed decision on the substances that you take for the viewers, right? Yeah. I want to kind of focus more on the shisha kind of mm. aspect as well, because as we know...
Do you mind if I just quickly, before yeah, we go yeah, to the course, shisha, of course. To ask you from a perspective of your clinics and seeing patients? So perhaps as somebody that's a young teenager gets into smoking, not knowing that actually all these you know, risk factors are present to them and it gets worse as they age. When you see patients in their later life and they've come with a chronic disease now because of their habits from a young age, do you think it really hits them then that why did I smoke so much? Do they regret it or do you think that yeah, they're so, oblivious?
So that's a very good question. Some people do regret it yeah. and unfortunately by that time they've developed emphysema or COPD and it's too late,
too late.
Or lung cancer for that matter, or other cancers, or they've developed other things like a stroke or heart attack, and it really hits them there. Mm-hmm. Some people, unfortunately, continue to smoke, even though they regret wow. having that condition, they continue to smoke. Mm. You know, either their willpower is not strong enough, or they say, well, I've got the condition.
Too late now.
It's yeah. too late now.
Willpower is a fantastic
Which is actually not yeah. true. Yeah. So certainly in the case of conditions that people can live with, yeah. and some lung cancers, not everyone dies from lung cancer, it's still worth stopping because you're doing more damage.
Yeah.
So the sooner you stop smoking, the better. Okay. Yes, you've caused damage. It's not reversible. But you're going to continue causing more damage if you mm. continue to smoke. Yeah. If you don't mind, before you go to the next question,
yeah.
for our viewers at home, there's a diagram, if we can put up for the viewers, which shows about 15 different types of cancer
oh, wow.
that smoking and tobacco and cigarette smoke contributes to,
wow.
to their causation. And the biggest one is the lung cancer. That the bigger the circle is, wow. the more contribution tobacco has. And that's from Cancer Research UK.
You know, anybody who knows people that have suffered cancer, yeah. I mean, I know young people, we often think, you know, they're immortal and, you know, these things aren't going to affect them. But I think when you see it, not only from a clinical perspective, but on a social, someone from your family have got it, you know, that's not, you know, by any means, yeah. if you can prevent it.
It's sad. I mean, I look after people with lung cancer and many other cancers, but in particular lung cancer. And I have seen people in their 30s with lung cancer.
Wow.
Not all lung cancer is smoking related.
Yeah.
About 7 in 10 are, and 3 Gosh. Out of 10 aren't.
If you had to pinpoint one thing, I know that obviously quit cigarettes, but if you had to kind of pinpoint one thing early in their life that they could have avoided that would lead up to lung cancer or any of those cancers, could you share something with that? Of course, quitting is quitting. Like there's no other remedy, but... Is there anything that the youth can consider, for example?
A lot of it is about the environment. Mm. Remember we talked about advertising and billboards and these subliminal messages. Mm. As for the youth, even adults, to be honest with you, a lot of it is about who's around them.
Yeah.
You know, what do their friends do? Do their friends also smoke shisha or cigarettes or what have you? How much influence does that have on them? Mm. You know, we have Islamically, we know there's numerous hadith which says, you know, you need to befriend people that are good because then, you know, they will have an impact on you, your friends have a direct impact on you. I'm not saying people that smoke shisha or cigarettes are bad people, but, you know...
It's the environment.
It's the environment. Yeah. That has an impact.
Yeah.
That, you know, and if you're surrounded by adults that smoke, the adults are role models to you, you know, what messages are you going to get, unfortunately?
Yeah.
That's the reality. You know, and apart from the effect, we know there's a physical effect as well. We know children whose parents smoke at home are more at risk.
Yeah.
It's about that environment. I don't know if that answers your question.
Yeah, no,
but also it's about what's going through that person's life.
Yeah.
If they're going through some stress in their life and they reach out to something that they think will help them de-stress, whether it's cigarettes or shisha or alcohol or drugs or whatever it may be, you know, whereas others reach out for the squash racket as I do.
Yeah.
I play squash. Or I watch my favourite and the best team, as Ali would testify, Manchester United, on TV. That's my way of de-stressing. Yes. Yeah. Oh, you're not a Man United supporter either.
I'm not a football fan. I'm speaking on behalf of everyone who despises Man United.
Out of respect for you, I'm not going to go into this discussion. We'll leave it.
We have so much to talk about. I know. Out of time, because we wanted to talk about the e-cigarettes.
Yeah, and the shisha as well.
I'm disappointed that we haven't been able to cover those. Yeah. I don't know if we can squeeze it. I think
what we can do potentially is actually do another episode and do the things that we've not discussed as another episode.
Yeah.
Perhaps, yeah. Definitely.
Thank you so much, though. Yeah. Again, fascinating time just flies. And as ever, you know, God bless you for your knowledge and sharing it with everybody. I'd benefit.
Me too, 100%.
I'm not a smoker, but you know, it's nice to know the facts and you know,
it is.
People around you. So it's definitely informative.
Fantastic. Any other points? No.
No.
No. So it's been fantastic to have you on the show. As Zara said, we're going to be joined by Said Ali Nawab after the break. Inshallah. So stay tuned. Thank you.